Hello all, and welcome to day 11 of Videopalooza 2023, and we're reviewing Star Trek Strange New Worlds Season 2, starring Anson Mount, Rebecca Romijn, and Ethan Peck as Captain Christopher Pike, Una Chin Riley number 1, and Spock, respectively, but of course more, because there are more characters than just that. Strange New Worlds is the best new Trek for being an ensemble cast. And boy, it was an ensemble season. You had your serious episodes. You had your comedy episodes. You had your off-the-wall musical episode. You had your animation crossover episode. And then you had your dynamic and dynamite cliffhanger episode. To me, Strange New Worlds is the best of what some call Kurtzman Trek. It's ran by Akiva Goldsman, and I like the episodic nature of Strange New Worlds, and Season 2 is that. You can have overarching stories, which Strange New Worlds does indeed have, and you can have great episodic television, which Strange New Worlds is also that too. Let me say one thing out of the gate. I'm not going to spoil anything. I will only use stuff from the promotional material, but I thought Subspace Rhapsody was both a fun, why hasn't Star Trek ever done this before thing. Also a little bit annoying because it was weird seeing them break out in song every 5 seconds. Or at least it felt like that. But it was a fun episode, and it was a one-off, and they Star Trek explained it. I'm not going to go how into they explained it, but they explained it in Star Trek terms, so why wouldn't it be any different than a black hole or a sucking in time bubble that happened on Next Generation? Why wouldn't it be any different than any one of those episodes? Because they Star Trek explained it, and I think they Star Trek explained it pretty well. Was it my favorite episode of the season? No. But was it the worst episode of the season? No. It had great personal drama. It had fun romping drama. To me, it's a more complete, more dynamic season than Season 1. And I hope Strange New Worlds gets better and better and better. I think the characters of the new chief engineer is getting flushed out well. I think Uhura is being flushed out well. I think Spock and Lieutenant Ortegas, Nurse Chapel, Dr. Umbanga, all of those characters, we know more about those characters and are more invested in those characters than anyone in Discovery save Michael Burnham. That's why I think Discovery is such a lackluster show, because with the exception of just a couple of characters in Discovery, we don't know that crew. I can say we know most of the crew of Strange New Worlds. I can list off people, and we know things about them, and we meet characters in the season that later become important in Star Trek lore. Is Season 3 going to be the coming up of one of Star Trek's greatest engineers? We don't know. Is Season 3 going to be an excellent jumping off point to lead into TOS? We don't know that either. But I can tell you this. Season 2 was an excellent follow-up to Season 1. And to me, Strange New Worlds is my favorite Star Trek in the Kurtzman Trek still going. Save Lower Decks, of course, because Lower Decks is gold. But Lower Decks is also animation, so that's a little bit You will see a review of Lower Decks, the new season, after it's done and over as well. But I'm just telling you that Strange New Worlds, there are its detractors out there on the internet, and that's fine. Detract away. I understand what you're saying. The things that detract from Strange New Worlds for you are viable and real. But I personally enjoy Strange New Worlds for what it is. Is it perfect Star Trek? Is it like Next Generation or DS9? No. It's its own thing. And quite frankly, it's more narratively better than Voyager. And it's narratively better than even Enterprise. Both the series lost their way somewhere along the way. So, I'd say it's middle tier Trek. Now, of course, it's not over, so it could get better and better and better. But it definitely left me with a huge cliffhanger. A cliffhanger I want to see the ending to. A cliffhanger on the epic of when Picard got taken from the Enterprise by the Borg. So it's on that level of epicness because we're in the heat of the moment with this, and we need to see what happens next, and we may not see it for a little while due to the writer strike and the actor strike, which I'm totally okay with, because when we do get to see it, I know it's going to be of a level of where it needs to be, point blank. But with that said, my review for Star Trek Strange New World Season 2 is 9 cups of Earl Grey tea out of 10. It does have its points where you're like, why did it go where it went? But it's still a great show. If you've seen Star Trek Strange New Worlds, let me know what you think about it in the comments down below. But until next time, you know I make videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday, 12:30 p.m. Central, 10:30 a.m. Pacific, 1:30 p.m. Eastern. Please like, comment, subscribe. If you want to see more, please ding the notification bell to be notified when I upload a video. But tomorrow will be day 12 of Videopalooza, so you'll be getting another video tomorrow because we're in the throes of Videopalooza. It's going to be the book review for Joe Kenda's Killer Triggers. And you will want to see that one for sure. But until next time, happy watching, live long and let's do this right. Live long and prosper, that's the best I can do. And until next time, I'll see you again soon, and peace.